Kev, you know the Lakers as well as anybody. Let me start there, since the intrigue starts at number two in the draft. What are the Lakers going to do?
Dan, it's starting to look a lot like the Lakers are going to surprise people. I know everybody, including me, a while back projected them to take Jahlil Okafor at number two. But, you know, I now expect the Lakers are going to take D'Angelo Russell, which would really shake things up there at the top. And they've just been wowed by Russell here in the past couple weeks, and he had a much better second workout with the Lakers than Okafor did. And the Lakers are just starting to come to a consensus that the special guy, the one that they believe that will be a guy to build the franchise around is Russell more than Okafor. Ultimately, it'll be Mitch Kupchak's call, but it's really looking like it's going to be Russell for the Lakers.
Okay, are you hearing that it's going to be that, or that you're just guessing, educated guess?
No, that is the majority opinion inside the Lakers front office. Ultimately, it's going to be Kupchak's call. He you know, if he wants to go his own way, you know, he has that prerogative with the support of ownership.
Wow.
With Jim Buss. But you know, I expect the Lakers to take Russell, which, you know, could shake things up if the Sixers don't want to take Okafor because they have such a load at the front court. Then, you know, you got Phil Jackson run a triangle with Jahlil Okafor. Could be pretty interesting, too.
Wow. All right, wait, what's going on with DeMarcus Cousins? Is he still in play here?
Yeah. I mean, the Lakers are definitely interested. I just don't see how that deal gets done. The Lakers are opposed to including Julius Randle in a trade for Cousins. And, you know, beyond the fact that, you know, it's hard to imagine the Kings wanting to help out the Lakers and bring them back to prominence. But how the Lakers have the assets to get Cousins without including Julius Randle is a mystery to me. Randle's been, you know, already, you know, obviously missed almost the entire season last year, but he's looking like a monster in off-season workouts already, and the Lakers are super excited about what he's going to be. So they don't, you know, their model is they believe they can bring in top-flight talent via free agency eventually. Someone will take their money, you know, sooner or later. And so, you know, for them to deviate from that plan and give up their young assets to bring in Cousins as opposed to keeping those assets and bring in, you know, LaMarcus Aldridge or whoever it might be, you know, it's not what the Lakers prefer to do. But, you know, if they can get him for the number two pick, then absolutely, it'd be interesting.
Wait, but they love Russell. But they would give up the...
Wouldn't you, Dan? I mean, you give up, you know, a rookie for proven, you know, star who is 24 years old, no?
If it's just straight up for the number two pick?
Well, obviously, that would be salary considerations.
Yeah, because there's Randle and Clarkson, I hear, and if you give up... Here's how. I don't want DeMarcus Cousins as the face of my franchise when Kobe
retired. I agree with you.
So I would rather bring in LaMarcus Aldridge. I'd rather bring in who I wanted to bring in instead of this is the best guy available right now. If you believe Russell is the real deal and you got to have a point guard in the West, then you bring him in, and then you start to build your team. You can't build this overnight, and I know that's what the risk is, and they want to, you know, placate Laker fans, but you can't do that. I don't want it overnight. I want it to be built like you want it built, and it's going to last for 5 or 7 years.
Well, the Lakers are with you, so I expect that to happen. I would be surprised if the Cousins thing goes down with the Lakers. And that's one of the reasons they're so sold on Russell is they believe he has that special character that, you know, Jerry Buss believed that you couldn't just build a team with superstar talent. He believed that when it came to superstars, you had to have guys who had the right character, who you believed in, you know, as representatives of the brand. And that's their belief, not only for Russell. They think Randle has that leadership ability, too. So that's their vision if they can get somebody to take their money in free agency sooner than later.
is it notarized that Kobe is only going to play this year and that's it?
No. I mean, I certainly allow him the prerogative to change his mind, and if the Lakers somehow can be pretty good,
yes.
then there's certainly the possibility that he would stick around and maybe even play for a little money to shut up all the critics on that front. But you know, I think everybody would love to see that, Dan, but after being around Kobe for these past, let's say, 5 years, I mean, there has been a shift for him. And his, I guess, joy about all the work that he puts in behind the scenes, mm-hmm. that it has become a little bit tedious, and obviously going through rehab isn't fun for anybody, and he's had to do it over and over. But even just the maintenance work, the ice baths, the film study, all the things that he used to revel in that he didn't feel like were work, have become a little bit like that, you know, after a 20-year stretch. And so for that reason, I'd be surprised if he didn't call it quits after this coming season.
Kevin Love opts out, and barely a ripple. Should Cleveland be nervous at all, or is this just going to be, he's going to stay there, he's going to sign his new contract? Give us an idea of that crystal ball that Kevin Ding holds.
I still hear from too many people that Kevin Love wants to play in L.A., you know, be here where he was for UCLA, where, you know, his girlfriend, whatever it is. I still hear from too many people, too many Lakers people believe it's still a very real possibility that he just wants to get his life in order and wants to come in and play where he wants to play. And obviously it's going to cost him some money, you know, long term to do that. But if that's what he wants, if he's ready to make that life decision and not be the third fiddle in Cleveland, then, you know, it's his prerogative to do that. So I think he's still a very, very good possibility. LaMarcus Aldridge also is starting to be a guy the Lakers think they can get. You know, they're going to spend their money this season on this offseason on somebody, because they don't want to carry it over another year when they'll, you know, everybody's going to have cap room in 2016. They're determined to get somebody this offseason. It'll be interesting to see.
Okay, but is Kevin Love, it's not going to be a sign or trade that he's going to just say, I'm leaving and I'm going to the Lakers?
Yeah, that's the Lakers' hope. Yeah, for the same reasons that, you know, we talked about with Cousins.
Wow.
And if you want to play for a winning team, then that's, as we saw from Carmelo and the Knicks, you know, that's the better plan, as opposed to you know, ravage the team you're going to. And so that's the Lakers' hope. That's their model, is we are a free agent destination, and thus, you know, we can make it happen. It hasn't happened yet, obviously, but they believe that it will.
Well, that could change things. If you get Russell, you do have Kobe for one more year, you bring in Kevin Love. Now, all of a sudden, you have something that says there's a brighter future here.
And that's exactly what the Lakers need, is they need to do something to get a piece in place, because when 2016 rolls around, whether it's Kevin Durant or anybody else, they know that they're much more attractive as a winning destination if they already have at least, you know, some pieces ready to surround that player. And that's why, you know, if it doesn't cost too much to get a guy like Cousins, that you might say he's the franchise player right now, but, you know, actually have it in mind that he's a piece to go with the franchise player in 2016, or whoever, you know, whoever you feel is a better leader, if you can get DeMarcus Cousins on the cheap, which, you know, I wouldn't count on, though.
Kevin, good to talk to you. I know you got a busy 24 hours here, but thanks for joining us.
Absolutely, Dan. Take care.
All right. Kevin Ding from Bleacher Report, their NBA senior writer.